Have you ever paused to wonder how your favorite yogurt is made? In recent years, yogurt has become a star in the culinary world. It's not just a tasty treat, it's also a healthy food option that's packed with probiotics and protein. Over the last few decades, its popularity has skyrocketed, and for good reason. With its diverse range of flavors and forms, from Greek to whipped, from drinkable to frozen, there's a yogurt for every palate and occasion. And it's not just a breakfast staple anymore, it's found its way into smoothies, desserts, and even savory dishes. The rise of yogurt in the food industry is a testament to its versatility and its perceived health benefits. But behind every spoonful of this creamy goodness is a fascinating process that begins with the humble milk. Now let's dive into the fascinating process that transforms simple milk into your favorite yogurt. It all begins with milk, fresh from the dairy farms. This creamy, white liquid, the very essence of life, embarks on a journey that will transform it into the tangy delight we know as yogurt. This journey starts with a carefully controlled journey from the farm to the factory. Ensuring the freshness and quality of the milk is paramount, and to achieve this, refrigerated trucks come into play. Imagine large, gleaming vehicles humming along highways, their precious cargo kept at the optimal temperature. Once at the factory, each load of milk is received with meticulous care. The milk, still redolent of the farm, is tested rigorously for quality because the best yogurt starts with the best milk. This stage of the process is more than just a delivery, it's the first important step in the transformation of milk into yogurt. Once received, the milk is ready for the next stage, standardization. Standardization is the first major step in making yogurt. Now, what does this mean exactly? Well, standardization is all about adjusting the composition of the milk to make it just right for yogurt making. This primarily involves reducing the fat content and increasing the total solids in the milk. You might be wondering, why do we need to do this? Well, it's all about improving the nutritional quality and stability of the yogurt. By reducing the fat content, we're making a healthier product with fewer calories. And by increasing the total solids, we're ensuring that the yogurt will have a nice, stable consistency. So, you see, standardization is a key step that helps us transform ordinary milk into a nutritious and delicious yogurt. But that's not all. After standardization, the milk undergoes another important process called pasteurization. Pasteurization was named after its inventor, Louis Pasteur, a French scientist who came up with this method to kill microorganisms in food and drink. So, how does pasteurization work? It's quite simple, really. The milk is heated to a high temperature for a short period of time. This heat kills off any harmful microorganisms that might be present in the milk, making it safe to consume. But that's not the only benefit of pasteurization. It also helps to denature the whey proteins in the milk. Now you might be thinking, denature the what now? Well, whey proteins are a type of protein found in milk. When they're denatured or changed in shape, they help to improve the texture and consistency of the yogurt. So, thanks to pasteurization, not only is our yogurt safe to eat, but it also has a smooth and creamy texture that we all love. With the milk now standardized and pasteurized, it's time for homogenization, but we'll save that for the next scene. Stay tuned to find out more about the fascinating process of yogurt making. Homogenization ensures a smoother, creamier end product. Now, what does that actually mean? Well, in the world of yogurt production, homogenization is the process of breaking up fat globules found in milk. This is done using high pressure to force the milk through small nozzles, which fragments these globules into much tinier ones. The result? A consistent, velvety texture that we've all come to love in our yogurt. Plus, it prevents the fat from separating and rising to the top, keeping the product uniform throughout. But the journey doesn't stop there. Next station, Fermentation Town. This is where the magic happens, where ordinary milk begins to take on the tangy character of yogurt. But how does this transformation occur? It all comes down to a special culture of bacteria, typically Lactobacillus bulgaricus. Picture this, these tiny bacteria are introduced into the homogenized milk, where they get to work, happily munching away on the lactose or milk sugar. As they feast, they produce lactic acid as a byproduct. This acid affects the milk proteins, causing them to tangle up and form a semi-solid structure, or what we know as curd. But it's not just about texture. This process also imparts that distinctive, tangy flavor that sets yogurt apart. It's a delicate balance. And the mastery lies in knowing just when to stop the fermentation process to achieve that perfect yogurt tang. And how do they know when to stop? Well, remember that lactic acid we mentioned? As the bacteria continue their feast, the level of lactic acid in the mixture rises. When it reaches a certain point, it signals that fermentation is complete. It's like the bacteria's way of saying, job well done. So there you have it. From creamy homogenization to tangy fermentation, each step is a crucial part of the journey, transforming ordinary milk into the delicious yogurt that graces our breakfast tables. Fermentation also results in the production of lactic acid, which signals the end of this stage. And with that, our yogurt is one step closer to being ready for its final tasty form. Now it's time to add some extras to our yogurt. Just like a chef adds herbs and spices to a dish, the yogurt producer adds unique ingredients to enhance the taste, texture, and shelf life of the yogurt. These are the additives we're talking about. Sugar, honey, or fruit might be added to make the yogurt sweet, or perhaps a savory blend of herbs and spices for a yogurt dip. But flavor isn't the only reason for additives. Some, like gelatin and pectin, are used to give the yogurt a pleasingly thick and creamy texture. Others, like probiotics, are added for their health benefits. These friendly bacteria can help support a healthy gut, adding yet another reason to the list of why yogurt is a fantastic choice for a health-conscious snack. And let's not forget stabilizers. These are ingredients like gums, starches, or proteins that help maintain the yogurt's consistency over time. They prevent separation and keep the yogurt looking and tasting its best even after days on a supermarket shelf or in your fridge. So we have our yogurt flavored and stabilized to perfection. What next? It's time for packaging. Packaging is more than just a container. It's a crucial part of the product that protects the yogurt from contamination, maintains its freshness, and makes it convenient for you to enjoy. Yogurt may be packaged in single-serve cups for a quick snack on the go, or in larger tubs for home use. And it's not just plastic or glass containers. Some yogurts are packaged in squeeze tubes for kids or even in drinkable form, perfect for a quick breakfast. The packaging also serves another purpose. It's a canvas for the brand to communicate with you, the consumer. Through the packaging, they can tell you about the yogurt's ingredients, nutritional information, and any special features like being organic or lactose-free. Packaged and sealed, the yogurt is almost ready for the shelves. And there you have it, a journey from the humble milk to a delicious pot of yogurt ready for you to enjoy. But before it reaches your breakfast table, there's one final step. In the world of yogurt making, it's not all about the taste and texture. A pivotal part of the process is quality control, ensuring that every spoonful you enjoy is not just delicious, but safe too. This is where the yogurt undergoes rigorous safety testing. We're talking about checking for microbial quality, confirming the degree of pasteurization, and scanning for any potential contaminants. It's like a final exam, but for yogurt. Think of quality control as the guardian of yogurt production. Its job is to ensure that the yogurt you're enjoying has been made to the highest standards. It's about maintaining the integrity of the production process, a process that's been refined and perfected over many years. The goal is simple, to ensure consumer safety and product quality. That means making sure that every batch is just as good as the last. It's about consistency in taste, texture, and nutritional content. And let's not forget, quality control is also about guaranteeing that the yogurt is pasteurized correctly. Pasteurization is crucial in killing any unwanted microorganisms. It's a vital step in making sure that the yogurt you enjoy is safe, wholesome, and ready to eat. But quality control doesn't just stop at safety. It's also about ensuring the yogurt's taste and texture are spot on. This includes checking that the fermentation process has gone as planned and that the yogurt has that characteristic tangy flavor we all love. To sum it up, the journey of yogurt from the farm to your spoon is a meticulous and carefully managed process. It begins with the reception of fresh milk at the production plant and ends with the packaging of the final product. Along the way, the milk undergoes standardization, pasteurization, homogenization, and fermentation before various ingredients are added to give your yogurt its unique properties. And there you have it, the journey of your favorite yogurt from the farm to your spoon. Now, the next time you enjoy a cup of yogurt, you'll know exactly how it was made.